Welcome to the Glam Avenue. Today we are filming this look. Yes, I'm always extra. I have an extra white fur coat because why not? Okay, so today we are filming this look that I have on my face and I'm looking hella cute. But anyways, thank you so much guys for tuning in. If you're new, welcome to the family. And if you're an oldie, thank you so much for tuning in and remaining loyal to the GRWM. Do you want to know? So basically this hair I got from a Timaha bundle. Pretty sure you guys saw it already from the date night docu-series. And more than anything, the intention of this particular tutorial is for the cut crease. Anyone who follows me on Instagram already knows that we've been building it up to get to the cut crease. And before I uploaded a how to flatten your brushes for a perfect cut crease. Anyways, this is the tutorial. Tune in and enjoy. All right, let's get right into it. Grab a drink. Quick disclaimer, my gel is off. Actually, it's not gel, it's nail polish. Grab a drink. Today we're sipping on some... What am I having today? Brutal 8. I actually just recently switched up to Brutal 8 because I almost felt like it's a van. My body's almost immune to it. I'm not even like getting drunk. I can like kill a six and not even like... Just be like tipsy, you know? So I decided, let's switch it up a bit. Right, so what you're gonna need is the Beauty Glaze palette. If you do, you have it. If you don't, you don't. But the main color that we're gonna need here is just this dark brown. Which one? This one. It's this brown. And then I'm gonna buff that out with an orange. As you know, this is lazy. Hey. Right, so we're gonna buff that out with this orange and then cut the crease and set the crease with that white and then put on some really cute glitter on top. Okay, so let's go right into it. Let me grab my mirror. And what you wanna grab is an eyeshadow base. Any eyeshadow base really that you have, you can use, but I'm using, this one is from Essence. So you just set your lid. I already did my brows and the one eye, obviously. The rest shall be done at another time. So all you're doing really here is just like pressing it into your skin and blending it out so that you have a clean canvas, as the professional makeup artists say. Right, so as we're blending that, just want to make sure that there are no harsh, not really harsh lines, but there are no creases, you know. Just get right into it. I know with my eye is like extra, has extra meat, so there's a lot of meat going on there. Anyways, I use my Yardley Absolute Translucent Powder just to set that eyeshadow base there. Happiness. Just quickly grab your brown. So we're gonna use that brown again. Okay, I can't find the brush that I wanted to use there, but I'm just gonna use a flat brush like that. No, it could be cleaner than that, but we are here now. Actually, let me get the right brush. Right, we're back. So the brush I was looking for is actually this Urban Studio brush. Got these as a set from Clicks. Can't remember how much that cost me, but it's a story for another day. So basically, I'm just gonna try and come a bit closer to you guys so that you guys can see me. So basically what you want to do, you want to place this dark brown eyeshadow just right above your crease so that you can bring it up nicely. Right, pigments. What? Come through, pigments. Yes, we love it. So you just literally place it right above your crease. So you're not blending yet. So you just literally just place it there. Ooh, pigment, sis. Pigmentation, coloring, all things nice. And then I'm just gonna go in with my Saharan palette from Juvia's Place. So with that, we're gonna go in with this orange. It's like a burnt orange color. It's called Jamila. Interesting names. Juvia's Place always has like some really interesting names that they used to name their palettes. So you just go with that burnt orange and you place it literally right above where you placed your dark brown. Just place it there, then you blend. Hey. Hey. I have zero idea as to why I am playing the yanos on a Wednesday, because ain't nobody turning up. It's actually Tuesday, not Wednesday. But yeah. So you just want to blend that out. You know. I heard someone saying you shouldn't blend your eyeshadow right to your eyebrows. And I was like, sis. Do you, babe. Do you, babe. I want it all the way up there. This is just how I roll. So, sorry, you go back with that brush that we used earlier to place the brown and you just kind of blend that harsh line there. Because it needs to look like a... It needs to look photoshopped. You know? So that there is no need for Photoshop. That is just to remove any harsh lines, and I'm literally using effort that is like minimal to none to blend it. See, look how cute it looks now. So, but because as you blend the brown, you kind of lose that orange a bit. You can still see it, but you just lost it a bit. So I just like going back in with that color again. Blend whenever in doubt, blend some more, sis. So I'm happy with that. I'm happy with that. Now, let us go into cutting the crease. So obviously that brush is a little dirty because I was using it earlier on for the other eye. So to cut your crease, you can use anything from a concealer, but I just like using my essence again, that eyeshadow base, to cut my crease. And I just really like placing it here to kind of warm the product. There is no logic behind that. I don't know why I do it. I just do it. But I'm just gonna try and be a slightly closer now so that you guys can see. So you can either use this brush. I mean, this is really a flat brush. So I don't know, I really hope you can see it. It's not focusing. Is it focusing now? There we go. Right. Is that right? God. There, it's a flat brush. So if you want to know how I flatten the brush, you can just look at my video that I uploaded before this video, where I share how I flatten my brushes. Okay, so you can either use this one or the other one, but I just like using the other one. Let me go back with the other one, actually. This one also flattened. Half of my brushes are actually flattened. So yeah, I think the product is warm enough and you can go right into it. Oh, this brush is not clean, sis. So you just go right ahead. Oh, I need to really wash my brushes as soon as I'm done with this. Okay, so what you want to do is just to kind of identify where your crease is going to end. You just kind of place the eyeshadow base rather there and you just blink, look up. See, that'll actually give you a guideline as to where. And then the rest is just, you know, history. You really just, you know. You see how it's almost impossible for you to make a mistake? Because your brush is flat. Like, that's what I like about using flat brushes. Because that cut crease is going to be straight cut and as smooth as an MF. And you just kind of drag it down to the rest of your eyelid. So just, I normally go right above. So you know how you place your eyeshadow base there and then you look up, right? So I normally just go slightly higher than that because I just like have hooded eyelids and they kind of swallow the cut crease. And that is not the point, sis. I want you to see it. You know, why is our music off? Now see how clean that is. Let me just define it a bit more. And voila, voila, my effing voila. Oh my god. I really love it when my cut crease come together like this. Now see how crisp and clean the line is. So that's why I feel like, well, I mean, unless you're not going for this type of look, you know, then fair enough, you don't have to cut your crease, but I'm impressed. I like my cut crease pretty sharp. So let me just fix that music situation. I'm gonna be back. Now that we have sorted that situation out, you go back with that dark brown. So you just want to blend it out there at the end. Right, so you just place the brown right there. You should know. You just literally place it there at the edges and do that. Blend it out. Then go back to the Judas place, go back to that white I was talking about, that white, that's the white you're gonna use. So I use that to just set the eyeshadow base, really. We go look cute. Yes, 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 yes. And then this is actually from Essence. I got this from a package that they sent me, right? And it's full of glitters. And initially when I got it and I opened the package, I was looking at these glitters. I got excited, but then low-key I was like, girl, where on earth are you gonna walk around with that much of shimmer, you know? So it's a very pretty, it's like, I wouldn't say metallic, somewhere between metallic and glitter shade, I think. So I really like this. I'm gonna go in with this. So this is like it's actually a pink. I know it doesn't look pink on camera, but it's like a pretty pink that has, let me just swatch it for you guys so you can see it. And it just has this pretty blue and purple undertone. I don't know, like, it just gives me makeup orgasms and I am happy with that. That's just looking pretty. I don't know if you can see it clearly, but wow guys, I really hope you guys are not like, we don't see the hype, what are you talking about? But yeah, I think it's just super pretty and I love using, applying this particular shade using my finger, actually, you know, because I just feel like metallics and these glitter based shades come out better with your finger as opposed to using a brush. But that's just me. But then again, it's just me. It might be weird, but I just feel like legit it comes out prettier with guys, the yellows, guys, have taken over. Sit down. The yellows have like taken over for sure. Use a finger to blend that brown in so that it doesn't look harsh, you know? I think it looks mad pretty. I really love this. Ooh. Hello. You want my numbers? Yes. 0783 Right. So a bit of a drink. So the one thing I'm not gonna show on camera is me applying lashes, because I know somebody on my previous video on the date night docu-series, somebody asked me how do you put your lashes on, and I was just like, girl, it is still a struggle. But nonetheless, we go right in. So I'll just do my mascara and then line my lash line, and then as soon as that is done, we'll be back on the foundation routine. The lashes are on, this is flicking vibes. Good vibes, but music is off. I'm gonna be back. This glam is not even done yet, but I'm already feeling myself. Yes. So we go in with the Perile Cosmetics Serum. Holy MF Grail. So about 2 drops should be fine. Just wanna warm that up. Oh, this is my song. So I just like pressing it into my skin. Just really press it into my skin. I've already moisturized, by the way, so I really love moisturizing my skin first before I use the serum. Although it's sometimes I wear it just alone, but it's winter and hydration is key. And I read somewhere, good guys, your neck actually ages faster than your face, which is weird, but well, got the serum on. Then we go in with the glow boosting. I hope you guys can see it. Oh wow, my camera just refuses to focus today. What? This is ridiculous. So this is just the glow boosting pore minimizing primer from Essence. Would have seen that on my docu-series already. It's got so pure. I'll sound hunnies. Yes, I'm cool. So I'm back. We're gonna use the new Holy Grail, and this is the Estee Lauder Double Wear. I could tell you a story about this. I mean, what? So of course, your fave, firstly you warm up the product. Like, I'm actually blushing. I feel like young Chanel product, because wow guys, coverage is vibes. But anyways, just let it warm and sit there, and just, you know, what a foundation. Like, I'm particularly happy and impressed about this foundation. Anyone who follows me on Instagram would have seen this by now. You guys probably know this by now. I'm obsessed with this particular foundation because it just blends like honey, sis. See, I feel like the keys for my foundation is firstly coverage. And then two, does it blend other products well? Like, in terms of when you highlight, is that going to blend perfectly with your foundation? I am obsessed. This just works perfectly. And so all you just really want to do is just, you know, put it all over that face. Really obsessed with this foundation, guys. And it's also mattifying. So if you guys have been watching my YouTube tutorials, you'd know that I really suffer from really oily skin. So if anything, in a foundation, I'm really looking for one, coverage, two, matte, a matte finish. And this foundation, and needless to say, Uguti, like, you know, the, I know when they launched the product, they had a concealer and a powder to go with it, but I never used their powder, but it still sit well on my skin. And that for me was like, yes. Go right in there. Hide that mustache! I look like a bloody man. And by the way, this weekend I'm gonna be probably vlogging my spa day. Because I had a lot of people on my Instagram like, oh my god, you're so fun to watch. Like, you know, can you just like consider vlogging? But that actually even started from my WhatsApp, because I'm always uploading these, like, yeah, I'm a special case. These Insta snaps. So you go with the brush just for more blending. I like the brush finish as opposed to the blender finish. So just gonna put some setting spray on that and really just, you know, let it blend into the skin, sis. And really, you don't have to put much effort to have this foundation blend into your skin, because GE1 babes, wow. I don't know who pulled through with this foundation, but whoever pulled through with it done did us a favor for sure. So you just really, you know, I mean, it looks like skin. Are you kidding me? It looks like my skin. Yeah. And I'm so here for it. Yes. Right, and then we're gonna go in and highlight our face. And to highlight our face, we're gonna use the almost finished Maybelline Fit Me concealer. I'm not sure what color this is, guys. It's color 35. I've been using this for the longest time. Almost finished. So all you really want to do is highlight the necessary areas, which is the under eye, and you just really go in, you know? Bridge of your nose and a little bit of extraness on the forehead. So I don't really like putting a lot of product on my forehead, simply because there's not enough skin to absorb the product there. So I just rather put in less product there than try and blend it the whole day. My under eye is already looking hello snatched. We like that. So you just kind of look up, so you really get into those creases on the under eye. And here you just want to blend a little bit upwards so that your under eye looks extra snatched. And we love a snatched face. So really, and then you blend it on the forehead, so that when the light falls, darling, falls on the right places. Okay, no flashbacks, no flashbacks. Right, somebody asked me what a flashback is. It's like when you take a picture. I have a few pictures where like my under eye looks terrible. And believe it or not, it was actually one of the most important days of my life when I got engaged this year in February. My under eyes were looking terrible. That's why, you guys, I had like such bad flashback. It's like, you know what, it's now. Look at Satan trying to win. So this beauty blender is already damp, and I got this from literally from Clicks. So you just wanna, so the reason I just go in with the beauty blender for when I'm highlighting is because, you know, you don't want, just want to get rid of any excess powder that's left there. Really, more than anything, you just kind of get rid of any excess powder. So you blend the, part of the reason why I don't like using the blender for my foundation is because it really absorbs a lot of product, and that just irritates me because that just wastes your foundation. It's annoying. So going in with the beauty blender on my under eye, I really like a bright under eye, but you know, not like extra and over the top bright type bright. And then I go in with this contour stick. It's actually a stick foundation, it's not a contour stick, but I call it a contour stick. It's actually an extra cover foundation stick from Signature Cosmetics, and it's in the color Dock Roast. So that's the packaging and everything. So of course we warm up the products. So normally I actually, like lately, right now because it's winter, I actually prefer using powder contour because it's just so much easier to blend as opposed to using a stick foundation. Because stick foundation, if you just throw it straight in your face, it also just becomes a bit tricky to blend. So I am down for this particular stick right about now. And also I have their contour palette, so that also really helps in terms of blending that. I know it probably looks really harsh on camera, but really it doesn't feel harsh. So I just quite feel like that's warm enough for me. That's the contour product that I was talking about there. So just go in with the contour brush, just like a really flat contour brush that helps you, it just gives you more control in contouring. Then you suck in those cheeks like you snatched. So when contouring, I really like just going right above my, slightly, not really right, just slightly above your ear. See here, this is where your ear starts, and you go straight there. And just blend that out, you know. Nothing hectic. We want to be snatched, but I mean, just always remember that you're still going to use another powder contour to set that, so that might just also harshly emphasize the That might just also harshly enhance the contour. So it's actually better to just, you know, go in with the contour as minimal as possible. Don't worry, still gonna blend it out. Just right about now, we are trying to minimize that playground of a forehead. So contouring essentially is just to not minimize but kind of distract you from looking from the area on looking. Ooh, English guys is a problem. But I'm asking because I'm Indian, but it's just a matter of, you know, slimming the parts of your face that you feel that are too big. So for example, for me, my cheeks are massive, my forehead is a playground. So I really like, you know, contouring those parts. Also contour the parts there, just like that, you know. I'd normally, like on a different day, I'd probably use a bronzer, but you know, you go right on the jawline, and that is to minimize the visibility of the double chins. Or else, if you have a really great jawline, and then you can go in. Yes. You're getting somewhere now. Really quick. We are totally getting somewhere really quick. So you just really blend that out. Now let's just quickly set the under eye. Now with the under eye, what I like to do is grab, so this is my contouring palette from Essence, also part of our package, that this PR package that they sent over, just, you know. And that is actually the Revolution Banana Powder. Hope you can see it. If you don't, hard luck. So we just sent your under eye to make sure it doesn't crease on your ass. You want to look up and just set that under eye. Oof. I've tried the Black Opal setting powder, but I've never been really impressed. I felt like, okay, let me not lie, I think I just caught the hype of the banana powder and the Sasha Buttercup, but I'm struggling to get the Sasha Buttercup powder, so at least I got my hands on this one, and I think it does a fairly good job snatching my face. So you also want to go in just right under your contour to emphasize, you know, the contour. You're still going to blend it out, of course, because it still needs to look natural, but still look like you stepped out of a magazine, low-key, you know. I mean, yes. Also set. So, but right here, I don't like putting much. Just enough is fine by me. Also on the bridge of your nose. You want to set the bridge of your nose and go back in and contour your nose. This nose is already looking like a 90210 type nose. So you really just want to blend it in. So you're still using the same contour stick that we used earlier on. Just a bit of the leftover that was left there. You know? Guys, makeup really excites me. It's weird. It is one of the weirdest things. And my nigga doesn't get it, of course. Just like, you know? Not everybody is obsessed about you, you know? But we love that. Ooh. Once I get that wig on, sis, you ain't finna recognize me, I tell you. You ain't gonna recognize me for sure. So just to set your cream contour, we go in. So I got this from a PR package as well from Signature Cosmetics as part of their new campaign that they were running. So I really like using, I just always feel like this dark brown is a bit harsh for my skin tone, so I kind of just go back in between. So this is actually a neutral contour situation. It's like a harsh for darker skin ladies, and this looks like a highlighter that they have pretty cool, but not my vibe. I barely use it. So you just go between the two colors to almost set your contour. Because cream contour, if you don't set it, it's most likely to... Alright, shopping. It's most likely to crease on you. So as well, you want to go there. Hey, I saw some other girl actually contouring their upper lip, which is interesting. I think I just want to try that today. Here's the middle part. Does it do anything for me? Maybe not. But anyways, let's sort out the music situation. I'll be back just a few. This is it. So we're almost done. So right about now, we're gonna go in with our blush. Same old blush from Black Opal in the color Ginger. Perfect for dark-skinned girls. So it's contour, blush, highlighter at the top. So we're just going to put our highlighter right above where our setting powder is. Apple of your cheeks and drag it back. Apple of your cheeks, drag it back. Apple of your cheeks and drag it back. So before we close up, before we remove that setting powder, we just want to grab and go back in with in the same pattern that we used on the upper brow. So we use dark brown. That eyelash is so unruly. And most probably quite distracting. You just line your under eye with the dark brown. And then go back with that orange again to blend that out. So it's exactly the same. It's in exactly the same order. Thank you. It's exactly in the same order. Blend out with the burnt orange. Is this interesting for you, bro?
No.
Are you trying to tell me something, which eventually... So it's just nice, bright orange on your under eye. And then you add a bit of bottom mascara. Apologies for that eyelash is so unruly. I'll fix that, it'll look better on camera and on the shots for this makeup look. Okay, I think it's low-key back in place. now I've got eyeliner in my inner corners, which is not looking cute. If anything, my favorite mascara is actually the 6PC from Colors ZA, but that's like all dried up. And normally what I do when your mascara is dry, I normally just put setting spray in it. Just loosen the particles again. Because when it's dry, it normally doesn't mean that it's finished. It's just dry. I'm trying to get rid of that black shindig that's going there. Eyelash is out of line again, and it's very distracting to look at. But yo, sorry for that. So you just wanna grab a powder brush and dust that off. All the setting powder that you have left there. Kind of blended contour, it looked a bit harsh for a moment there. So you really just, you know, brush this off and remove it. Spray some more. So it's actually the Wet n Wild Natural Finish Setting Spray. So I've moved away of actually spraying directly my face. I've moved away from spraying the setting spray directly on my face. Don't ask me why. I just feel like the makeup is shifting layers. Thank you. It's just 2 minutes. I'm almost done. It's kerosene. The harshness again on the other side. Spray on some more. So you just spray on some more just for the apple of your cheeks where you're going to apply your highlighter, because the highlighter is more effective when there's some setting spray. You're going to see. I'm not lying. You're going to see. So I go in with my Wet n Wild highlighter, which is now broken. But you still go in there and do that. Ooh, yes. Then we go in with a fluffier brush. And the reason I go in with it's a flat, fluffier brush. And I got this from Signature, but it is a highlighter brush. It's because it's just so much easier to blend. You see the magic? Do you see the magic? Yeah, blinding shits! And then, also on the other side, you go in. Oh. I had Annette ready to see me when I have my weave on. You see there in the background there, the Tamaha hair bundle is waiting for the girl. And then you go in also, just yeah. Also, at the bridge of your nose. So it's just to remove those harsh lines, just blend it out. You blend it out nicely. To remove any obvious harshness, because it's supposed to look natural. Stay steady selling these niggas dreams, because they stay selling us dreams, so might as well. So, let's have a sip of a drink, because wow, we are almost done. We are blinding. Yes. So also, you just want to go in with your any flat brush and highlight right about here. Yes. Ooh. Listen, when we say the lights are supposed to fall in the right places, this is what we're talking about. Just right under your eyebrow, put some highlights. Oh yes. Lovely. Isn't she lovely? Is that even a song? But anyways. The highlighter is mother effing blinding. So now I'm just gonna quickly go look for my brown eyebrow pencil, and we'll be back with my weave on and the whole shebang. So just use a dark brown liner to line your lips that are already hydrated, whether it's Vaseline or some moisturizing labello. Go in like that. Nada. Nothing intense really, you know. So this is just a no-brand liner. Then we go in with this nude lip from Essence. I love this specifically because it makes you look like you just got a lip job. It's plumping. It has like a stinging effect on your lips. I guess that's what actually plumps the lips. Looks so pretty. Love it. So this is what we're gonna use. Now anyways, everything's in order. Now I'm just gonna put on that wig, and that wig is from Atimaha Bundles, and the code is, I think it's called Shady Blonde. Pretty dope. So let's go put that on and slay the shit out of this day. Now this is the finished look. Cut crease done. Well, these curls didn't come out the way I wanted them to, in terms of, you know, I haven't got the spray yet, so I look, you know, kind of, sort of, weird. Well, that's the other side that looks weird, but this side looks pretty decent, I think. Ooh. Yes.